Hi friends, I am Snehal. So in the last video, we discussed about kinetic energy and work energy theorem. And in this video, we are going to talk about the conservative forces. So what is a conservative force? A conservative force is a force for which work done by the force or work done against the force does not depend on the path followed, which means that if there is some object, let's say at point A, and some conservative force F suffix C is acting on it. Now suppose we want to displace this object from this point A to some other point, let's say B. So there can be n number of different paths joining points A and B. So suppose this is path number 1, this one is path number 2. This is path number 3 and so on. So work done by the conservative force or against the conservative force does not depend on the path followed. Means that work done along path 1 will be equal to work done along path 2 and it will be equal to work done along path number 3 and it will be equal to work done along any other path joining points A and B. So if start point and end point of motion is same, then work done by the conservative force or against the conservative force is equal along all possible paths joining those two points. Okay, so this is the meaning of a conservative force. Then what are examples of conservative forces? So the examples are the gravitational force, the electrostatic force between the two charges, and the spring force. So now that we know what a conservative force is, let's consider an example of the gravitational force and let's check whether it is conservative or not. So suppose that there is this ball resting on this horizontal surface at point A and we want to move this ball from point A to some other point, let's say C. So we choose three different paths for this displacement. So this is path number 1, this one is path number 2, and this one is path number 3. So let's calculate work done against the gravitational force for all these three paths and let's check whether they come out to be equal or not. So the gravitational force acts in downwards direction and it is equal to m into g, where m is mass of the ball and g is acceleration due to gravity. So now we know that the work done by a constant force is dot product of the force and the displacement. And what is dot product? So dot product is magnitude of first vector into magnitude of second vector multiplied by cosine of the angle between two. Then what would be work done against a force? So work done against a force is just negative of the work done by a constant force. So let's suppose work done against a force is W prime, so it is equal to minus of W, and that is minus of F into S into cosine theta. So now let's calculate work done against the gravitational force for path number 1. So gravitational force is acting in downwards direction and it is equal to M into G, and then this path number 1 can be divided in two parts, a part from A to B and then from B to C. So work done against the gravitational force from A to B, suppose it is W prime AB, so it is equal to
minus of force into the displacement SAB multiplied by cosine of the angle between two. And how much is angle between the gravitational force and the displacement? So the angle here is 90 degrees. So it is cosine of 90, and cosine of 90 is 0. Therefore, work done is equal to 0.
So there is no work done against the gravitational force for displacement from A to B, because the force and the displacement are perpendicular to each other.
Now let's calculate work done from B to C. So work done against the gravitational force from B to C, W prime BC, is equal to minus of the force into the displacement SBC multiplied by cosine of the angle between two, and angle here will be 180 degrees because the gravitational force acts in downwards direction and the displacement is in upwards direction. So this angle is 180 degrees.
And what is cos of 180? So it's minus 1. So therefore we have this negative sign and minus from cos of 180. So minus minus becomes plus.
So we have work done equals to F suffix G into the displacement SBC. Now let's suppose this displacement from B to C is equal to H, where H is the difference in height of point B and C, and we have the gravitational force equals to M into G. So the work done is equal to MG multiplied by the displacement, which is H. So MGH. Therefore, the total work done along path 1, let's call it W1, is work done from A to B plus work done from B to C, and it is equal to MGH. Now let's consider path number 2. So the gravitational force acts in downwards direction and displacement is along this path from A to C. So now we have to resolve the gravitational force along two perpendicular directions, one perpendicular to the path and one parallel to the path. So let's do that. So this one will be component along the displacement. Let's call it F suffix X, and this will be component perpendicular to displacement. Let's call this one F suffix Y. So this angle is theta, this angle will be 90 minus theta, so this angle will be theta. So therefore we can say that F suffix Y is equal to Fg into cos of theta, and F suffix X is equal to Fg into sin theta. Alright.
So there is no work done against this Fy. So there is no work done
against Fy, since it is perpendicular to the displacement.
So we need to calculate work done against Fx only. So work done against Fx is W prime A to C, and it is equal to minus of the force
fx into the displacement s from A to C multiplied by cosine of the angle between two, and angle is 180 degree. And what is cosine of 180? It is minus 1, so this negative sign, and minus 1 becomes plus 1. So this is equal to fx into SAC. Alright, so fx is f suffix g into sin theta multiplied by SAC, and in this triangle we can say sin theta is equal to this opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So it is h divided by hypotenuse is SAC. So we can take SAC on the other side. So we have SAC. Therefore, SAC is equal to h divided by sin theta. And substituting that, we get W prime AC is equal to FG sin theta multiplied by SAC, which is h divided by sin theta. Sin theta and sin theta gets cancelled, and FG is m into g. So we have work done along this path number 2, which is W prime AC equals to mg times h. So work done along path number 2 is equal to work done along path number 1. Now let's calculate work done along path number 3. So unlike path number 1 and 2, this is a curved path. So how do we calculate work done along such a path? So what we do is we divide this total path into n number of small segments like this. So this is ds1, this is ds2, this is ds3, and so on. Then we calculate work done along all those segments, and then we add it up to get the total work done. So let's consider this small segment ds1. It looks something like this. Now I can draw a triangle like this. So suppose this is dx and this is dy, dx1 and dy1. So we have just seen that work done along path 1 and work done along path 2 are equal. So path 1 was like this, dx dy, and path 2 was like this. So I can say work done along ds1 is equal to work done along dx1 plus dy1. So work done along ds1 is equal to work done along dx1 and dy1. So the gravitational force is perpendicular to dx1, that means there is no work done along dx1. So there is no work done along dx1, since it is perpendicular to the gravitational force. And what will be work done along dy1? So it will be mg multiplied by this height. So it is mg multiplied by dy1. So work done along dy1 equals to mg into dy1. So work done along ds1 is equal to mg into dy1. So similarly, we can calculate work done along ds2, ds3, ds4, and so on, and we can add it up. So we have total work done along path number 3, w3, equal to work done along ds1 plus work done along ds2 plus work done along ds3, and so on, and it will be equal to mg into dy1 plus mg into dy2 plus up to plus mg into dy suffix n. We can take mg common. So we have dy1 plus dy2 plus up to dy suffix n. So if we add up heights of all those small segments ds1, ds2 up to dsn, those are dy1, dy2 up to dyn, then what we get is the total height difference between points A and C. So this is equal to h. All right. So I can say, therefore, the work done along path number 3 is also equal to mgh.
And this path number 3 was any random curved path. So what we can say is, work done along any path joining points A and C will be same. Alright. So therefore, what we can conclude is, since work done along any path joining points A and C against the gravitational force is equal, the gravitational force is a conservative force. So now for the completeness, let's see the definition of non-conservative force. So what would be a non-conservative force? A non-conservative force is a force for which work done depends on the path followed. And what are examples of non-conservative forces? So the examples are frictional force, the liquid drag, etc.
So if we consider a wooden cube resting on a horizontal surface at point A, and we want to displace it from point A to some other point B, so we know there will be some frictional force opposing the displacement.
And now obviously the work done along different paths will be different, since the frictional force always opposes the relative motion between the objects. So if length of the path is more, the work done will be more. If length is small, then work done will be less. Alright. So frictional force is non-conservative force.